Want to make your Python programs more interactive? Asking users for input is the key. After watching this video, you'll know exactly how to ask for input while avoiding a common beginner mistake. To get familiar with the syntax, we'll write the code for this simple program that asks for a user's name and outputs a customized greeting message. In Python, the easiest way to get user input is to call the input function. To understand what the input function does, let's run the cell. As you can see, the function call created an input box under the cell. At this point, the program is waiting for the user to enter information in the box. This is fine, but without more context, it's hard for a user to know what to input. To prompt the user for a specific input, we can provide a message as an argument to the function. Since we want the user to enter their name, let's pass the string, "Enter your name." Now when we run the cell, our prompt is displayed before the input box. Much clearer. Once the user inputs their name and presses enter, the input is displayed in the output box. That's fine, but remember, our program should greet the user by printing hello, followed by their name. To create our greeting message, we'll first save the return value of the input function to a variable called name. Then, we'll write a print statement that outputs hello, followed by name. Now when we run the cell, the user is prompted to enter their name, and the custom greeting is printed. Great! In this program, we ask the user to input text, but we can also use the input function to ask for numbers. However, when asking for numeric input, beginners often make a common mistake. Let's see what that mistake is and how to avoid it with another example. This new program will ask the users for two numbers and add them up. For example, to add 1 and 2, we run the cell and enter 1 and 2 as inputs, and get 12? That's not what we expected. Why did this happen? We got 12 because the input function always returns the user's input as a string. So, the plus operator concatenated the two variables instead of adding them. We can confirm that these variables are strings by using the type function. Number 1 is a string. Luckily, numbers represented as strings can always be converted to integers or floats. To avoid working with data of the wrong type, it's good programming practice to immediately cast user inputs to the data type we expect. For that reason, we'll cast the user's input to floats using the float operator. Now we can safely assume that both of our number variables are floats. When we rerun our code and enter 1 and 2 again, we get 3. Great, now you know how to collect user input and ensure it's the right data type. This program will work great as long as the user enters numbers. But users don't always follow directions. This can lead to errors that crash your program. To keep your code running smoothly when using the input function, check out our video on error handling in Python. We left a link in the description. We're working on lots more Python explainer videos like this one, so be sure to subscribe so that you don't miss out. If you found this video helpful, be sure to share it with a friend. And if you have any questions or topics that you'd like to learn about, please let us know in the comments below. We'd love to hear from you. Thanks for watching!